appreciate you watching. Today I'm headed over to a street not too far from my shop to pick up a unique looking vehicle. It looks like a Chevy 5500 with a van chassis on top of it with a 2 5/16 ball on the rear. So I'll put a picture in here of it while we're en route to it. We sent a rollback out to grab it, but it's too long for a rollback. So the only thing I got at the shop right now is the red Peterbilt. I'm gonna run around here and see if I can hook it up with it. If not, I know I can grab it with one of the V100s. I'm not sure if the wheel lift is gonna reach the axle or not on this truck. So we'll get around here and see if we can get it hooked up, tow it, it's not going too far. It was an odd looking vehicle, so I thought I'd video it. Not your everyday tow, so. All right, we'll see you when we get on scene. Hope you enjoy the video.
Try to grab that frame right there, but I think I'm gonna grab the axle with the U-bolt cups.
Hello? Rutabagas and collards.
Two collards?
Thank you.
tip my receivers over so I can hopefully have enough width to grab the U-bolts on the axle. If not, then I'm gonna have to fork it by the frame. And there's nothing to keep it sliding, so I have to chain it in place. Try this again. Blocks under here because when I crawl under it, too strappy now. I don't want it to fall on me. Not that it would, but you never know.
You wouldn't believe how many people out there come up here and say, what in the world is that thing?
You don't mind if I put it on my YouTube channel, do you? Because I don't, you don't tow one of these every day. Yeah, this will be pretty cool just to see. So, I have it out of here about 15 minutes or so.
Yeah, Michael Boykin.
Sir?
No, Michael Boykin.
Michael Boykin.
Does heating and air work?
Oh, Boykin Heating and Air?
No, he's Michael Boykin HVAC.
I don't know. I probably know him if I saw him.
He's the one that built it.
I said, that's pretty cool there.
I'm gonna take these lights out and do the LEDs in here and close this in.
Right. Yeah, I wasn't happy. That was kind of thin right there. I didn't want to try to pick it up, and I was able to grab the axle, so that's
a lot stronger.
Whole lot safer. Yep. Yes. All right. Thank you, sir. safely get under here and don't have to really worry about the truck falling or anything like that. Make sure we don't have no brake lines over here. We don't. After I post this video, the hurricane will be gone, but just praying for all those people down in Florida. They're actually getting hit right now. Just praying for them and everything's in the Lord's hands. Hopefully it don't tear up Florida up too bad. Once again, checking for brake lines. I know a lot of you towers don't like to put blocks down under the tires. And believe me, I was the same way. 2 extra minutes to just put a block under there to be safe. Sure mean a lot to your family if something did happen. Hello. Ranger. Yeah. But you ain't got nobody that can get it out, do you? Okay. Alright. That's not your everyday tow there.
Yes, sir. I got you.
A little bit different. Just it was about that much too long for the rollback. That's unique there. Checking to make sure my hood's latched right now while I'm walking around. Let's see, steering wheel strap.
Keeping Wilbur busy?
Yes, sir, Mr. Wilbur. He's going on something else right now. Tell you what, Mr. Wilbur, I wish I had 2 more of him.
That's right.
That's a hard working man.
Yes, he is.
Appreciate it. Come on, hand. Hand that wanted to get stuck.
Trying to lock them up in there, huh?
Yeah, I don't want to leave them in it.
Don't do that.
Side right there. So I feel the rod for the seat way under here. That's what I'm gonna go to right there. Good and snug. Mirrors in, look so they don't blow off. Hood latch, safety chains, steering wheel tied twice. That we ready to rock and roll. pictures from my tow books. Rolling. Pull it up at this hole on level ground so I can check the air pressure in the tires before I start a video. I had to pump air in the front two tires. So, pull up here and check them again. Hello? I want to make sure that one was up too, because it was down in that hole. Man, I appreciate that.
They're good.
I did try. I appreciate it. All right, I'm going to get it on over there.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Viewers, we're on scene now. I'm gonna try to get some video footage of cutting loose. Pretty much what I normally do. I just reverse all my steps that from when I started till I finished up, and I just pretty much reverse them. That way I know I got everything taken loose. First we're gonna get our safety chains off of here. Probably need to come back about another foot, a couple of feet. Slide it. as y'all see, I reversed all my steps. Putting a whole lot to it. The main thing is going to get everything back and put it back in its proper places. That way, if next call, if I have to leave from here, everything should be right back where it's supposed to be. And then if Wilbert or somebody else has to jump in the truck, everything's where it's supposed to be. It don't always happen like that, but it's a whole lot better when it does. Okay guys, hope y'all enjoyed the video. Don't forget to comment, like, share. If you like our content and channel, please subscribe. And as always, stay safe out there, and we'll catch you on the next one.